Yo, what's up, guys? Welcome back. I wanted to do some arena. Before we start, let's do a wish and see if we get something amazing. Actually, before I start as well, I wanted to tell you guys something. If you look at the YouTubers, the Summon a War YouTubers, oh, time for a lot of arenas. Wow. If you look at all the YouTubers, you must see one thing, I think. You all probably know Shigo Framing Gamer. As you may have noticed, he has started to make different videos the other than me and Childish, for example. Because his videos are really targeted on the beginners of this game, and that's really smart of him. Because none of us is doing that in particular. I myself focus on more the end game player, the mid game till end game player, that I wanna attract to my channel. And Shigo Framer Gamer is more about the mid, well, the starting player and the mid game player. So that's something you guys have to notice. If you wanna do a YouTube channel or you wanna do on Summoner's War, because I have no clue about the rest. But keep in mind that you might have to consider what your channel is about. Like, you have to think about that, because it could be that you are doing the exact same as some other YouTubers, and you're worse at it. What do I mean by that? It doesn't mean like you cannot do arena, for example. It just means that try to bring something that people haven't seen yet, and I know it's a bit hard, obviously, but try to bring something that's, I don't know, new. Like, you can still do arena, obviously, if other YouTubers do arena. It's just that I see some YouTubers that are really small still, and they kind of do the same as everyone else, and I'm like, I don't think many people will watch you. It will grow eventually, but it will grow real slow, you know? So I think some people just need to figure out what they're good at and what they can bring to the table. For example, my trademark has been the reviews. I'm not the only one that does reviews, but I'm one of the few people that started doing them, and I still do them till today. It's become a little bit harder with the growth I've been through, so I gotta say it's I need to try to make a new format for that, but I'm working on that. But like, if you have something that you think you could bring, I don't know. I mean, it doesn't have to be something new. It just has to be something that's people will come that people will come to your channel. Like, I actually think most of the people that come to my channel come here to see either end game PvP or want a review. That's the two biggest groups I think will that come here to see my channel. Obviously, I do make some guides and all that, and I think a lot of people watch those as well. But that's, I think, the base of that YouTube, you will do that. But if you're like, if you are like a lower player, you're like 25 and you start a YouTube, I don't think there are many 25s that start a YouTube, but for example, I'm just making an example, guys, and you start doing guides on how to do something, keep in mind you need to make sure that people understand you correctly when it comes, because if you are level 25 and you make a guide how to beat something, it has to be very specific on those lower players, otherwise nobody's gonna watch you, because level 25 is not really a good level to say like, hey, let's make a guide, right? So be aware of what you are, where you're at, and be aware what people will attract to your channel. You can see YouTube as a business if you want to, because you have to be really careful. Well, no, you don't have to be careful. You have to be really good at what you think is going to be good for the people. Like, you have to make a target audience. So, and this is what I like when I watch Secret Framer Gamer. He is a business guy because he has run his two businesses, I think. So what you see back in his channel is that he's exactly targeting an audience that hasn't been targeted too much yet. And he wants to attract that to his channel. And as you guys know, he's a big YouTuber, so he does know what he's doing. And I think a lot of people like his videos. I think also some people do not like his videos. Especially, I think the endgame players don't, well, they might watch his videos because he's a funny guy and he's fun to watch at. But he's, I think most endgame players are not too excited for his videos. But mid-game and early-game players, I think they're really excited to see all their videos because he's discussing some starting points and things how to be done at the beginning of the game, which is pretty good. I mean, I could make those videos as well, but I don't really... I'm looking for people in that rating. I'm not, like, in that level. I'm kind of looking for people that are higher. I mean, I'm far, like, mid-game players. I want to attract them and end-game players. The endgame players is pretty hard to attract, so I'm more focused on the mid game. There are some endgame players, don't get me wrong. Some of you guys are maybe even way better than me. And some of you guys are around the same experience, and some of you guys are mid game. But that's what I'm trying to attract. I don't know. Maybe that's something you guys can do. Maybe you can tell me if there's... what your reason is why you watch me. Is there it could be anything really. If you think I'm funny, you can say that. I doubt I'm funny because I never really make too many jokes, but but like if you think like my content is interesting to watch, or if you think I can teach you something, tell me whatever you attract to my videos, because that's pretty interesting to see, because this way I can also get a good idea of I actually got what I wanted when I make a video, or that I actually do something that I'm not aware of but that you guys like. So that's pretty cool. But this is actually just going out for all the YouTubers basically. Make sure that you know what you're good at, and make sure that you make the videos so that people go to your channel because of those videos. I'm not saying like everyone can grow bigger if they're good at what they're doing, right? But if you would be making certain videos, I need to make an example. Let me think for a quick moment. Okay, let's say it like this. If you are level 40 and you want to make PvP videos, that's completely fine because it's fun to watch the progression of teams. But if you struggle in the arena and you still make a lot of poor decisions, don't go out of your way and start making guides on how to counter certain setups. I don't think anyone has done that in the YouTube world right now. I don't think there's any YouTuber that made a comment about how to counter a certain setup when they weren't aware of how to. So I think everyone that's doing a YouTube right now is doing a great job. But I think sometimes I watch a video and I think like, yeah, this has been done over 1,000 times and it's exactly the same. It happens a lot with guides. I think I did it as well, but it happens a lot with guides. If you would see someone make a guide on how to beat a Giants B10, for example. I've made a video on that as well, and I was definitely not the first. And it's, I just thought I could make it a bit more, how do you say that? A bit more specific on the stats and all that, because a lot of the videos didn't show that. So that's what I thought about it. I thought I could make it a little bit more specific, so I made that guide. There is also, I also see some people do like guides on other stuff, like halls of dungeons, halls of magic and all that. And that's actually not bad, because I think so there are not too many good guides out of there to do that. But there's some people that kind of just copycat what another guy just said, and then I'm like, come on, man. You have to be a bit more different. I mean, I probably do some things that I hear or see from other people as well, but I always try to bring something new to the video. Obviously, I have my standard videos, which are my PvP videos, and my so helping summoners. That those two are my standard videos, so I make those all the time. Reason for that, I think personally, if I watch YouTube, you know, I like to watch people just do their thing, fight in arena, and I just like to watch those videos while I'm playing myself. Now I'll never watch videos when I'm doing arena almost, because most of the time I make a video about it, but I like to watch that on the background, you know, and just chill. And I think a lot of you guys actually do like that as well. I'm not sure, but I just guessing that a lot of people like to watch a video while they're playing the game, and maybe catch on to something that they find interesting. So that's are my two basic videos that I kind of do consistently. The helping summoners always depends on how much time it has, because those are really time invested. I need to invest a lot of time there, but that's why they don't come out every day, obviously. Besides that, well, I probably could have done it every day with the amount of viewers I sometimes get. Or requests, not viewers. But yeah, I sometimes make guides, and when I make a guide, when I can beat Giants Dragons B10, I will definitely make a guide on it, on how I think you should beat Dragons B10. Reason for that, I've seen a lot of people beat Dragons B10, but after beating them with the Fire Viking, I didn't see that many guides that I thought like, oh, this is really nice to watch. So I'm gonna try to make that as when I can do it. Like, if I cannot do it, I won't make a guide on it. Fuck. He's gonna die again. No! I thought he would go before. Damn it. Reset. Oh yeah, that's by the way, guys, there's a new guide out from Nick the Greek. He's a YouTuber. He's from the Cypher Guild, that's the rank 1 guild on the Asian servers. I don't know if they're rank 1 on Asian as well, but they were on global. Why do they have to attack my unit always? God damn it. But he made a guide how to get the most mana and how to get the most XP and all that. And I think it's a really good guide. I do have one point that I wanted to point out in his video that I don't understand why it's not mentioned. I don't really want to say it in this video, because I just made a comment to him personally, so it's in the comment section there, so if you want to know that, you can just read it there. It's nothing, like, his guide is really good, but I just thought, like, why didn't you not mention one particular zone, like, fuck it, I will say it here then as well. I won't say it too specific, but what I want to say, he said, like, he was farming a zone with a lot of water monsters, actually alone, only water monsters. And he was doing that because he could do that the fastest. But there's another zone, Aiden Forest, which also has only water. So if your unit is strong enough, why wouldn't you farm there? Because that's basically all water as well, so Lucian is still strong there. And if your Lucian is strong enough, you can do that relatively fast and gain a lot more XP. But that's just one thing I noticed that I wanted to say. I made a comment on this video, but I actually advise all of you guys to watch this video because that's a good guide. I think a lot of people that are lower level will benefit from the video. So yeah, I think you can just search him, Nick the Greek, on the YouTube stuff. If you cannot find him, you can always go to Childish videos, and you will see it in this description. Somewhere there will be a link to Nick the Greek, because he made a link to every YouTuber. So that's pretty good. But yeah, Nick the Greek is actually also a very good player. So I think he started a bit later than some of us. So he's not that big yet, but I think he will become a pretty big channel sooner or later as well. Depending on what he's gonna keep doing. Yeah, okay, let's now just focus on the PvP, because well, this match is kind of over, but I talked enough about all kind of random stuff, so let's focus on the PvP. This match was pretty annoying, to be honest. It took me forever to get Darien dead. Come on, crit already. I'll heal. God damn it. And I had no heal debuff on you. Come on. Get a crit, Lucian. Do it. Thank you. Yay. Damn it, he made it to the draw button. He's a bastard. I'm currently still negotiating about the website, the one that the guy that made it for me. It's not done yet, and I'm not sure if I'm if he's done with it or not. But I want to see when I'm when I got the ownership of the website, or the admin, I don't know what you call it. Like when I can edit the website, then I'll try it out and see if it's gonna be the one that I want to use. Because right now I'm not 100% sure if I can do everything I want on the website. I just started format, basically. I just started layout, so it's still a work in progress. But I want to get it done somewhere between now and 3 weeks or something, because I want to start making the website work, so we can. Yeah, so it's ready for the guild battles, you know? Because I think the guild battles will come to us pretty, well, not pretty soon, but at some point they will come, and I don't think it's going to take more than 3 months, so I want to be ready. And I want to actually move over the reviews to the website, so that will help me a lot. I still need to figure out how exactly I'm gonna do it, but that will come when I actually know how I'm gonna use the website, how I can use the website to help you guys. I still have a few reviews to do. I'm not gonna do them today. The reason for that, I have an XP booster up, and I want to make my unit to max level, so I don't really have time to make reviews today. So I'll do that in the next week, somewhere next week. So people that asked for me a review a few days ago, you'll have to wait. It will take a bit longer than normally to do the reviews, because I don't have too much time this week. Well, it's not like I don't have time, guys. It's more that I want to spend the time on my own account right now, and I don't want to spend too much time doing the the reviews right now because I need to level up my units and I want to get my dragons team running. And I think I prioritize getting Sigmar to level 40 max level over doing some of the reviews. Because the people that asked me, most of them also told me that they don't really have haste on it. Like, they just want to know some questions. They just want to know some things, like someone else's opinion on it, basically. So it's not like if I don't help them that they're stuck, for example. Not that that would matter, because I still do everything on my watch and not on anyone else's watch, because otherwise I would go crazy. I think if I would do that, I would actually be very quick to stop making videos if I would do things on someone else's watch. So I think that's important for you guys as well. If you want to help people, that's fine. Obviously, that's really good actually. But make sure you do it on your time and not on their time, because it's still pretty intense sometimes how much time you have to invest in making sure you can help someone. So if you want it to be a high quality helping video, basically, make sure that you got the time to do it and don't rush it. And when I say got the time to do it, that means that you're ready. Like, you don't have to do it when you're like when you're day off. You don't need to do whatever people want you to do, but you need to do what you want to do. I think that's a very important thing to know when you do anything, basically. And I kind of feel responsible to do reviews when people ask me. So sometimes I have to really tell myself, wait, do this first and then go for the reviews. Because I noticed when I done a lot of reviews, when I just wanted to get them out because there were so many people asking, I noticed that I sometimes did it when I was tired, and that's not too good. I mean, the review itself was still from high quality, but my excitement in the video was not that high, which I personally think is pretty important, that I am fit when I make a video and not when I do it at 3 at night and be like a bit tired and all that. I think that's important as well. But yeah, this is something I told in the comments before as well. I'm just talking about like everything except for PvP. I hope you guys don't mind that. Lucian would be good here. Yeah. There are people, I think a lot of people, that get sidetracked a lot in the game. Try to make up a plan. And for example, I will tell you what I've done, for example, to make up a plan. Not now, but what I've done in the previous few videos and whatever, my leveling. I made a plan to make my speed team. That was my first speed team. You guys remember when I was using my full wind team, right? Like with Orochi and Lucian and Shannon and Bernard. That speed team, I was trying to make it good enough to stick to Conquer 2 or Conquer 1, Conquer 2, Conquer 1, I don't remember exactly. I think it was Conquer 2. And after I was consistently in Conquer 2, I decided to make a defense team. And the defense team, I had an idea to make it a full light team because I had a Yona. So basically what I wanted to get was Darien and Belladon. So I got those two units as well. Up to max level and 60. But I was really focusing on them to get that done. And after that, I think on the way I got a Jameer. So you would say you got sidetracked by Jameer. I'm actually not sure when I got Jameer. So you would say like I got sidetracked by Jameer, It's kind of true, but I knew that he would be the perfect leader for my most of my teams, even in defense. So that's the reason why I actually put him on the front of my priorities to max him out back then. And I think you guys need to make sure that when you get a new unit, you need to make sure that you know that he's gonna help you in your current goal, or if he's not. Like, for example, if I would get an if I was doing my defense and I would have gotten what's a good monster? If I would have gotten an Hua, that's a good monster, Hua. I would not focus on Hua at that point because Hua doesn't give me anything when it comes to defense. So that's why, and as some people see, like, oh, I got a Hua, now I'm gonna make my Dragons team or something, while they were doing their defense team, and they get sidetracked by the new summon. So only if your summon actually is gonna be very useful for you when it comes to what your goal was, go for it. For example, if you would summon wow, I just can't get rid of that invite. What the fuck? If you can't get rid of the, oof, this is painful. They don't have speed though. That, so if I just, it's a bit risky. So if you have a goal to make a defense team, make a defense team, and don't get sidetracked by too many other things that are going on. Because that's just really, yeah, just not smart. Because then you will just not never reach your goal fast or at all. You won't reach your goal that fast. So try to make that plan. You need a plan to become a better player in a fast way. Damn it. Let's heal up. I want to kill the hellhound now because that thing hits way too hard and it's way too squishy. There we go. Let's reset everything. And heal up. This is a pretty cool fight. I got a little bit lucky with the hellhound not buffing, but I think I would have survived. Because Lucian died before he actually attacked. So then I would only have taken more damage from Zyros. But I think my units would have survived. Maybe Mara not, but the rest should have, so I could revive that, so that's not a big deal. Pretty strong team there. That's why I like Belladon so much. You can just take these teams down because they're banked on that they can survive the first turn, so they have no speed on the rest of the units. Ooh, definitely Lucian. Damn, Chasun. This is a really heavy healing team. Think I'll take down Aemon first. Even though I think Belladion is more of a threat, I think Aemon is just faster to die. He's gonna survive, I guess. Yeah, he's gonna survive. Fuck. Second round. I hope I can kill him now. Oh, Camellia is a crit damage Camellia, so I need to be careful. Yeah, that's fine. Bam! Oh, no crit! God damn it, no crit. Phew, no extra turns on Chisune. Okay, let's rape his Belladion. Nice. His units were pretty fast, was he had no speed leader, but still some of the units went before mine. And I do have a speed leader, so I should have Should have gotten the faster units. But these two are pretty slow. They didn't really have speed runes, so I guess that's the reason. Damn it! Shouldn't have been a crit. Should not have been a crit. I want Belladon to not crit and put the defense break on so Lucian can hit really hard. That's basically what I want. God damn it, you have to crit, don't you? It's okay. It's not a tank Mila, so it's quickly dead. She didn't really do that much damage, so. What? Oh, I thought it was 1550. I was like, what? What is he doing in this area? Ooh. I think I actually want to take Mara and try to one-shot Tyros. I don't know if I can, but let's see. Okay, I'm lucky that she doesn't use her fanatic. So I might be able to crit. Yes, thank you. Okay, now the damage is gone, so let's take down Chloe. I think that's the weakest. Those damn Zyruses are always scary to face, but most of the time they're actually not that painful. It's gonna get healed anyways. Unless I get one more turn. Come on! Nice! Oh, that's so nice. Now let's take down Chasun. Slowly but surely. Who's surely? I don't know. Come on, defense break. Damn it! I want the defense break so I can kill the unit. Defense break. You gotta resist me all the time. I might be able to. Oh, oops. I wanted to say I might be able to kill him when I reset and do my last skill, but that's not gonna happen. Damn it. Maybe I can take him down now. Come on, crit. Yes. Nice. Can I kill him? Yes, I can. Nice. Going good so far. I think I now finally have. Yeah. Jesus, that was. I had so many invites. Whoa, 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 whoa. I have to abuse you. I have to abuse the fact that you. The thing is, I'm gonna get AoE'd by the. I'm not sure if this is the best way, but we'll see. Who shall I kill first? I think I'll kill you first. No, never mind. Don't want. I think I'll kill the one of the Arnolds first. If I can. I'll kill him first. I'll try to kill him first. Need to heal. Otherwise he will die very quickly. Oh, the stuns are real. Defense break. Please do not get stunned. That would be epic. Oh, I think you will die. No! Can I dispel? Oh, I don't need to. Kill! Come on! Yes, it's enough. Yes, it's enough. You will die now, but that's okay. Might get extorted. But I think I can survive that. No stun, that's good. Now I can kill something, I think. Not sure. Good. Nice. Okay, GG. The reason why I went for the Arnolds first, because the AoE will kill my Mara all the time if I did not do that, so I wanted to get rid of that. Oh, well, I thought he had a defense break there. Oh well. And now they still focus on my unit and I can let him die slowly. And then do a clean shot when he's low. So that was the reason. I think I'll dispel this unit. Cause yeah, nice. Goodbye. Ooh. Oh, I should have healed maybe. Oh, doesn't really matter. No crit. God damn it. Nah. Can I kill him? Is it enough? Yay, it's enough. Nice. Hey, oh my god, Bomber is here. Oh yeah, this is exactly where I made my unit for. No, not you. Need to kill Belladon first. He's the biggest threat. After that, Vanessa is the biggest threat. Yeah, there we go. Now this is the target, which sucks. Yeah, ooh. Oh, this sucks. I could have maybe one-shot at that guy. Now I cannot. Damn it. Oh, that's painful. Yep. Pretty sure I need to defense break him in order to kill him. Ah, maybe I can just kill him before as well. No, I don't think so actually. Okay, don't get extra turns. Please. Okay, this should be enough to kill him. If I get the turn. Yeah, wasn't a crit, but it was enough. Vanessa is the next threat because she has a defense break, guys, that's why. Okay, heal up. Let's not lose you when we don't need to. Seal of fire. Bam. Now let's kill the last reviver, and we're out of here. Okay, need to heal soon. No heal ready. Too bad, let's do some damage then before we die. Extra turn. Yeah, nice. Ooh, extra turns are in the... Ah, I did the wrong skill. That is okay. I'll win anyways. Nice. Like, this setup was relatively easy because of my unit. Oh my god, Bomber. definitely not want to take Mara, I think. Well, I'm thinking maybe of actually do to take this setup and then focus on this unit. Yeah, I'll do that. I'm not sure if this is the best way to attack Omega Bomber right now, but when his reviver dies, I should have a good chance of winning the fight. But the defense rig is pretty horrible, especially when they start on my reviver. Damn it, he's just it. Okay, that's one. It's gonna be on him for a long while. Extra turn. Damn it. Oh, come on, one turn on one unit. Damn it. I needed one extra turn. Bam. Bam. Let's just heal. Well, our heal has gotten so much stronger. I've been upgrading our skills quite a bit. Stupid. Come on. No. Get extra turn. Extra turn. No. Damn it. Kill him. Is it enough? No. No. Fuck. Okay, he actually has no defense break. That's pretty good. He has to die. I need extra turns, come on. Extra turn. Damn it. Extra turn. Extra turn. Come on, kill! Yes! Oh, nice. Let's actually go for... I don't know. He's gonna die. Alright, Belladon seems like a correct target. Extra turn! Get it! Nope. Want Ymir to get an extra turn. Then he should be dead. Nope. Not allowed. Extra turn. One more. Nice. Oh. I was pretty scared that they went for Iona, but Iona is so tanky that I could take all the damage without too much trouble. So that was pretty nice. But this defense definitely targeted the correct guy, and sometimes it was pretty damn annoying that I... this attack is also really... based on the violent procs, because sometimes I just need a few violent procs to get the kill. But the thing is, I can try so many times because this defense doesn't really die quickly. Especially if you control it yourself, you know, because you can just time everything. So yeah, I'm not saying it won't die ever, but nice, beat Omega Bomber. He will beat me again. Didn't gain any ranks there. Oh, what the heck is this? This is a bit of a rough setup to beat. I'll try it, but I don't know if I can win. It's pretty hard to beat. Not sure. I think I'll go for Phoenix. Why did you have the attack break? Now he will heal. Okay, give me a turn before you heal to. Ah! This is never gonna be enough. Ah, damn it, I knew it. Fuck, I'll just kill him twice. Yeah, you're dead. Oh, nice, he didn't get an extra turn. Okay, the biggest threat is gone. Now the second biggest threat. That unit gets a lot of turns. Oh, I need to make sure to actually heal that. Can I do that? Yeah, well, fuck it, I'll go for the kill. Nah, they're actually not going for Jameer now because of that. Defense break here, even though he's super low. Can I get a turn before the tower? Nice. Bam, you're dead. No, fuck, you're alive. Now you're dead. It was a weird setup to say the least. I mean, Konamiya, and I don't understand it too much. I mean, what does she. Ah! Oh, for offense, I could understand taking this team, but for defense, I don't see the point in putting Konamiya in there. He's obviously a good player, so. Okay. Actually, I might be able to do it like this. I want to kill that fire unit, that fire Dragonite first, because that is going to be a painful unit. Oh, I needed that. I will try, but I don't think I can kill him now. Well, I can kill him. Wait. Yes, nice. That was actually pretty nice. Oh, fuck. I thought he had it. Oh my god. Pay attention, Blackie. Pay attention. It's not over till it's over. Oh, damn it. He's gonna get healed. Extra turn, Jermaine. Extra turn. Do it. Sometimes it's a little bit too much to wish for, I guess. No! He's dead anyways. Come on, kill! Extra turn! Extra turn! Extra turn! Okay, defense break. Get it. That's okay, don't. Yes, I thought Jashun would be healing already, but she was a bit slow. Let's heal up first. Don't want to lose her right off the bat. Again. This game is in the pocket, so that's nice. I was a bit scared that without the defense break, the Fire Dragonite would have survived the hit, and then I would have been in some more trouble when it comes to damage output of his team. But luckily, it was enough. So I'm really glad that Mara is that strong and in attack. I really look forward to when our skills are maxed out as well. Currently working on my Iona, on her skills. I needed three more, I think, or two. Two or three more skills and then I'm done. We got the devil one from today, so that speed up the process, because next week I'm gonna get another Devilmon. Two more guys, two more to go. Oh, this team, we fought against this team. No, we didn't. Lol. Actually, taking Mara is not the best thing I could have done, because now I have two targets on my head that will kill my unit pretty damn fast. Oh, that's pretty nice. No defense break yet. So she's safe for another turn, I think. If I can get the defense break on Darien, I'm... Ah, oh, damn it! Attack break. I'll still try to soul crush him. Come on. Is it enough? No! Fuck. It's not, but I'll still kill him because the reason he doesn't revive with too much health. Ah, never mind. That went out of the window. He's dead. Oh, maybe I can heal him. Yep, she's dead. Damn it. Okay, the trick is gonna be that they defense break some other unit and then I'll revive my unit. So not now. The next turn they should defense break something. Yeah, Jameer. So everyone will focus on Jameer. Now I can revive and have him relatively safe. Back alive. Unless you get two turns now. Damn it, that's stupid. Okay, this is not that relatively safe. Just now. Still get the attack break. God freaking damn it. Stupid slash. Actually, I'm more pissed off at the fact that I get the attack decrease than the armor break. I don't mind them killing it, but I do mind. Give me a soul crush, please. No! Stop freaking getting turns when I need your... Ugh! This is a horrible experience. Stupid ass Darien, I want you to die. But nothing goes perfect. I think I made a mistake by taking Mara here. That's what I definitely think. Come on. Let me soul crush you. Let me do it. Give me a turn. Give me a turn. Crit, please crit. Thank you. Finally. This is the start of your undergoing, mate. Took me forever to take down the correct unit, but I did it. That's fine. I think I can kill him. Just reset so I can do some high damage on my little friend. Die. Ah, no crit, damn it. Without crit, it's pretty useless. But I still kill him. I did 15 invites in an hour. That's not too bad on the Guardian rank, at least. That's I think most of that is because I can use Mara in a lot of fights and she does a lot of damage. Not that this match went really fast, but it does set a pace if you can take down a unit really fast at the beginning, which happens quite often. Okay. We have one more match to go and then, oh, we got two more if I could clear this list. Oh, a lot of fire. I'll try it anyways. Not sure if I kill Zyros first or the awkward girl. They're both really horrible to fight. I think I'll go for the awkward or the it's not a, how is she called? Wow, she's dead really fast. Okay, got rid of her, no revive, so that's good. Now I'll take some. Oh, nice! I got the attack break on him. Helps a lot. This doesn't help a lot. Ooh, fanatic. Yeah, just reset. Damn it! No, don't get too many turns. Crit. Think you could kill him with a crit. Okay, it's GG now. This setup is pretty scary, but the Zyros and the other unit are pretty squishy. So, yeah, it's a good setup, that's for sure, because Chloe can protect them. So if you cannot get rid of the shield fast enough or cannot kill them enough, they will kill you pretty fast. Goodbye, Iona. Yeah, it's crazy summons to be honest. If you look, I mean, I shouldn't say too much because I got Iona and Ymir here as well, but. Yeah, let's just do it. No crit, damn it. Okay, nice. Now I got two invites again. Wow. I keep clearing the list. It's insane. I'm gonna stop the video here since we're already in 1 hour. And I kind of want to start doing something else. I will do it because I have 10 buffs, but I will do it off camera. And because I want to do some other stuff as well right now. Want to eat first. Hey, Mystical Scroll. Want you? Let's see what we get, guys, out of this Mystical Scroll. Lightning? Nope. Oh, yes! There's lightning. Wow! Wait, what? A 4-star? Whoa! Woo! It's a Rakshasa. Too bad I'm not the fire one, but I like it. Oh, cool. Nice. Might use her for at some point. Wow, that was epic. And that's why you should buy Mystical Scrolls out of the shop, because you can get lucky. Fail, successful. Rank 26 now, that's pretty crazy. Yeah, it's not worked out. So, doing pretty good at rank 27. I'm liking it. I actually cleared the list twice today, which is crazy. Oh, the rank 1 is not even that far away from me. I actually thought I would have been a little bit lower right now because I thought a lot of people would have played throughout the week and be higher on rating, but they are not. So that's all good for me. Yeah, that was it, guys. Thank you guys for watching. 1 hour of well, I think it's cool PvP. and talking about other stuff, and I'll see you guys in the next video. If you liked it, by the way, subscribe if you like to, that would be nice. You can also like the video, that's also nice, like the thumbs up, that's a good button. Don't really know what I get for that, if you thumbs up the video. I think other people see that you liked it, or is that only when you share? I don't know. But if you like my content, please subscribe, because then you see every time when I post a new video. Yeah, see you guys later, man. Bye.